Get ready to match the stars from MASH, Gary Berghoff, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Hope Lang, Richard Dawson, and Patty Doyle as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rayburn!
Johnny-o, hello friends, thank you for joining us. Well, you're a beautiful bunch. I greet you one and all, and especially the new kid on the block. Yeah. Two-time Emmy Wimmer.
Yeah.
See how
Get
nervous
the
I am?
Yeah.
Have Hope Lang on the show. She's won two Emmys in television. She
I would make her a two-time
Emmy Wimmer.
Winner.
That's right. And she
Wimmer.
Was also nominated for an Oscar, and she's just a nifty little actress. And to greet her properly, we must give her a little polite applause while I plant a little kiss on her lip.
I like the show a lot.
Just want you to know, Hope, you are among friends.
Now, let's no Wimmers, just losers.
That's right. Marge Gassman and Kathy Porter. Marge is the current champ. She's won $5,600. I know. She doesn't look it, but she's just a little old farmer lady from upstate California.
That's right.
And she grows kiwis. You're laughing. You've never heard of kiwis, have you? Well, I have neither until she told me about them, but everyone knows I've talked to about them say they are delicious fruit. About that size, right?
Right.
Is this a profitable venture?
Well, one vine that I saw, a tree, they turn from vines to trees because they get large. It was 7 years old. It had 900 pounds on it. And at the going market then was about 2 years ago, $1.69 a pound.
Holy mackerel.
One vine.
One vine. How many vines have you got?
42.
Would you like to get married? How do you feel about older men?
Well, I've got one. I've
oh, got you've got one. Oh, awesome. Anyway, she was challenged by Kathy Porter here. Kathy is the one with the teeth on her right, and the game ended up in a tie. So what we have to do is go to a tiebreaker, and we will indeed do that right after we do this. All right, here we go now. This is the tiebreaker now. We've turned off the lights here. There we go. One tiebreaker for each. The one who's matched the most will be the winner. Kathy, you may have A or B.
I'll try A one more time.
A one more time. This is it. For Kathy, we have this one. Did you know? The bionic woman has wooden parts.
I didn't know that.
No, I didn't.
That may come as news to you, but the bionic woman has wooden parts.
Good gravy.
Now, it's true. In fact, she has a cedar blank. Wonderful.
I've been gone longer than I thought.
Yeah, where have you been?
I've been around. I've been around town.
Oh, I thought you went to Hawaii for a long time.
Went to Hawaii to my yogurt store.
Oh, yeah. Is it going well?
Very well, thank
Good.
You.
Good. Yeah. Are you kidding me? Brett.
What?
Aren't you finished?
No.
Well, look, come on.
The third day of that tanker store medicine. She doesn't know where she is.
Brett has been ill recently with these unfortunate things.
Actually,
these canker sores in her mouth. She's been taking a lot of medicine, and it's softened her brain a little bit, I think. Here it is, Kathy. Did you know that the bionic woman has wooden parts? It's true. In fact, she has a cedar blank.
Cedar chest.
Cedar chest. They really respond to you, Kathy. She said cedar chest.
She'll never get termites.
That's right.
In my house, you would.
Pathetic award of 78.
It's the same thing. I
Charles
just tried
is awarding
to,
you.
I tried to change it a little bit. I just said cedar closet. Which is like a...
Now, wait a minute.
Very sick woman.
Would you like to see the inside of my mouth?
No, we don't want to see the inside. No.
Just now, hearing it is enough for us.
Oh, I'm sorry. You missed that one, Brett. But God. Once in a while, you have to miss one to prove you're human. Yes?
Chest.
Chest it is. But Kathy, that's two of those, or four, depending on how you look at it. Now, here's your first
yes.
time. Yeah. Yes. Take a deep breath, I hope, and show us your answer.
Well, it's a little small, but it is a chest.
Oh, it is.
Pop it in there.
No, there's a lot more. Put it right there in the slot there. I wouldn't say that, would you, Richard?
Not at all. I look at it this way. Chest.
Chest. Well, Kathy. Now, here's the lady with a unique vocabulary and a nifty bow tie.
Lights up in the dark, you know.
It does.
Yes. Chestalaria.
Chestalaria. So, in her part of the tiebreaker, Kathy has 5. Now, Marge, you have to do 5 to go to another tiebreaker, which we would do if it happened, or if you match all 6, you will win. Her says, Stella said, it's a little strange being married to a baseball umpire. He even yells, batter up when we go to blank. Little strange being married to a baseball umpire. He even yells, batter up when we go to blank. Bye. All right. It's such a joy to see you. Been trying to get you to do this for a long time. All right. Marge, are you ready? They're ready over there. Stella says, it's a little strange being married to a baseball umpire. He even yells, batter up, when we go to blank.
Make love.
When we go to make love.
I know the other one's better, but that's...
What is the other one?
Bed.
Bed. When we bed. Go to bed?
Bed, yeah.
You think they're going to say bed?
Well, my first answer is the answer, but...
Yeah.
You know.
No, make love is what we have to accept, but I just want to check your rationale here.
There is.
You think they're all going to say when we go to bed, but you said make love.
Well, what's the difference? I mean...
Now, wait a minute.
No.
It is not necessary to be in a bed... When you, I mean, you're a farm girl. Haven't you been out there under... No, you haven't. You've heard of haystacks?
May I say something?
What's that?
You're looking at a single woman, and I can tell you there's a hell of a lot of difference.
Oh, there is.
6 nights out of 7.
Okay. She said...
Well, you're looking at a married man, and I can tell you there's a hell of a lot of difference in my house, too. I said bed.
Bed. Okay. Marge, that's one. Now, you must match all the others. Bed is what Brett says, and that means that Kathy wins the game. Right there in that little blue dot. Gonna shake your hand, because you've been wonderful here.
Thank you.
We've had a lot of fun here with Marge Gassman. She's been a good sport and a good winner, too. $5,600 for Marge Gassman. Goodbye, my dear. Now we got this message for you. Kathy Porter's won her first game. She has her $100. Now she's going to try for a big amount of money. You could win over $5,000 here. Ready?
Yeah.
Well, you don't sound very ready to me.
I'm ready. I'm going to go get them.
Okay. We polled the studio audience not too long ago, Kathy, and we said you write down your best answer to this, the San Francisco blank.
Oh.
The San Francisco blank. Now, the answer they gave most often will get you $500 if you match it. If you match the second most popular answer, you get $250. And then for matching their third most frequently given response, you get a total of $100. And you can get some help here from 3 of our 6 celebrities.
Richard.
Earthquake.
The San Francisco earthquake is 1.
Brett.
The San Francisco Bridge.
All right.
And Gary?
Gary, what's the third spot here, which is a tough one?
Trolley.
The what?
Listen, I don't have to suffer these indignities, folks. I have an Emmy.
That's right. And he has another show, too. That's it, eh? The San Francisco Trolley.
Well, no, I've got a better one if you want it.
You have?
Yeah.
What?
Lovemaking. No.
Terrific.
Bay.
What?
Bay.
San Francisco Bay. All right, that's it. The San Francisco Bay, the San Francisco Earthquake, and the San Francisco Bridge. Now think it over carefully and choose one of those three, or you have the option of giving one of your own. What do you want to do here?
I'll go with Richard and say Earthquake.
The San Francisco Earthquake. Well, it really shook things up, didn't it? And a lot of people remember it. Brett was there. That's it. The San Francisco Earthquake is what we want. Let's begin down at the bottom as we usually do and reveal the $100 response.
Well, there it is, right off the bat. That's got to be up there a little bit higher.
Well, it's got to be either Bridge or Bay up there on top, right?
What about Giants?
49ers.
Charles says it's going to be the San Francisco Kid. I said that is the Cisco Kid, sweetie.
Cisco Kid. No, the 49ers are the Giants. One of those, that ought to come up there somewhere. What's under the 250? Bay. And the big one, what do you think? You don't know. Okay, already slide it. San Francisco Bay Bridge. Isn't that interesting? Well, Brett would have won it. That's right. San Francisco Bridge. Okay, now you got $100. You're going to play for 10 times that amount or $1,000. Whoma do you call, Anna?
Richard,
okay,
please.
Okay, Richard. Here we go. Good luck to you, my dear. This is worth $1,000 to you, and it reads as follows. Blank donut. Blank donut. D-O-N-U-T. Blank donut. Kathy Porter, give us the answer that Richard has written on that card, and we give you $1,000.
Chocolate donut. Oh!
That's not your favorite, is it? What is your favorite donut?
Jelly. I forgot jelly.
You what?
I forgot jelly. Oh, boy.
You like jelly better than chocolate?
Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry. We can't change your order now, madam. You've already given us the order, and the cook is cooking them up already there. So we've got one chocolate donut coming up here.
I thought you were a jelly donut.
Jelly donut, yeah. She looks like the jelly donut type, doesn't she? Well, watch it.
Yeah,
no, I'm only kidding about that. Kathy, you've got $200, and you're still a champ. You're going to meet another player, so let's bring on Donald Jones. How are you, Dan?
Scared.
We welcome you.
Thank you.
And we ask you to tell us a little bit about the Donald Jones story before we begin the competition.
Okay. I was born in Birmingham. That's in Alabama. I grew up in Ontario, California, not Canada.
Right.
I've been living in Chicago, and now I live in San Francisco.
Yay! Yay. You've been all over the lot, haven't you?
Well, 33 years. Yeah. And when I'm working, which I'm not, I usually work in sales and marketing.
But at the moment, you're between engagements, as we say.
No.
You're looking, right?
Exactly.
Well, I hope someone who's watching, or needs somebody who's good in sales and marketing, will look you up and give you a job. Because you look like a peachy kid, a snappy dresser, and a nifty dancer.
Jane.
That's your only suit.
It's not too late. Go to a commercial.
Oh, really?
Save yourself.
Oh, all right.
Anybody who starts with Wimmer and then commercial, you got to get out of here.
Oh, no, I don't want to get out. I want to talk to Donald Jones a little bit longer here and there. Oh. Hey, wait a minute while I get the table up here. There we go. Thank you very much. Now, let's go here with Donald Jones. Ask him to make a selection of A or B.
B, please.
B. That's this one. Right. I knew it was one of those two. Nancy the nurse said, I work for a doctor who is so cheap.
How cheap is he?
Give them another chance.
One more time?
Yeah, because they're good.
It's your last chance now. If you don't make it this time, we're going to throw you out. We got a whole bunch of people waiting
outside. No, give them another chance.
Nancy, the nurse, said, I work for a doctor who is so cheap.
How cheap is he?
Beautiful.
That's right.
Except
for you.
We'll go on the road.
Bella, you're hired. That's all. Okay. No. He's so cheap, he reuses blanks.
What?
What?
He was talking.
Were you talking again?
Yes.
I work for a doctor who is so cheap, he reuses blanks. Nancy, the nurse, said, I work for a doctor who is so cheap, he reuses blanks. I hate that fake and stare when you do that to me, Charles.
Look over here.
Oh, here's another man. I work for
so
a doctor.
Cheap,
I work for
reuses.
A doctor. Nurse said, I work for a doctor so cheap he reuses blanks.
I was cute, eh?
Okay. Cute is not the object.
Oh, okay.
I mean, you can be cute
I don't think you like
and match. That would be absolutely ideal. But cute alone is not acceptable. Hello there, Donald.
Hello there.
Nancy, the nurse, said, I work for a doctor who is so cheap, he reuses blanks.
Tongue depressors.
Tongue depressors are perfect answer. See that? With you. Gary, what do you say? He said tongue depressors.
Tongue depressors.
There's one for him. Stick out your tongue.
Oh. I can't.
You know, now here you've had this problem going week after week. And we come up with a question related to the mouth, and you probably didn't even think of tongue depressor, did you?
No, if I put a tongue depressor in my mouth, I'd go crazy if he was such pain. I said he reuses patience.
Not even cute. Not only doesn't. What do you say?
Sort of
I don't have the education that they have, Mr. Jones or Mr. Burgos, so I don't know how to say those fancy words. It's those sticks.
Those sticks. We'll count it anyway, Chuck. Work for a doctor so cheap, Hope, he reuses blanks.
Kleenex.
Oh! That is cheap. I mean, that really is. Yeah, you don't like that question? I didn't think it was too bad. Did you, Richard?
No. My doctor uses Band-Aid.
Band-Aid? Yeah.
The ouchless kind,
right,
of course.
The ouchless.
Oh, yeah, he's got class.
And he puts them on with rubber bands, right? What do you say to that?
I said tongue depressor.
You said that. That's three for him. Now, let's see what we have for Kathy here. Her first round question, Phil said, something went wrong at the movie theater. They showed a love story and a cartoon at the same time. It was shocking.
Oh, dear.
Robert Redford was making love to blank. Love story and a cartoon at the same time. And Robert Redford ended up making love to blank.
There, I think I got that one.
Good for you. Glad for you. Love story and a cartoon. Same time. Wonderful.
Sammy talk.
Phil said, something went wrong at the movie theater. They showed a love story in a cartoon at the same time. It was shocking. Robert Redford was making love to blank.
Minnie Mouse.
Minnie Mouse. How about that? That's a marvelous answer.
Yeah, I know. That's why I'm so embarrassed with mine.
Why?
I said Daffy Duck.
Daffy Duck. Well?
I thought it was really weird, you know.
Yes.
And I thought Minnie Mouse would not be as weird as Mickey Mouse.
Well, that would be more shocking, I guess. Yeah. Yeah, I got the idea, Charles.
Bugs Bunny.
Oh! What do we got? Minnie, Mickey, and Bugs so far? Kathy is looking for Minnie. What do you got?
I've got Mickey.
Hello, Robert Redford. She's only kidding if you're watching. Richard?
He was actually dating Olive Oil.
Olive Oil. Yeah.
Kept slipping out of bed. I don't know what the problem.
Okay, Patty Deutsch.
He also had a little thing going on the side with Porky Pig.
Oh, dear.
Porky Pig.
not
so there we are in round one, 3-0 in favor of Donald Jones. Don't nobody move because we got this message for you. Ready? Here we go. No, we're not going anywhere. Our time has expired for today, and so have I. No, we'll look forward to seeing both of you next time when we'll go to round two, scores 3-0, favor the challenger. Well, Hope, how does it feel to your first time around here? We enjoyed having you, and you're a barrel of laughs, and your answers were so-so. No, your answers were marvelous. No, you're terrific. We're going to look forward to seeing you tomorrow here. Join us in Match Game 78. I'm Gene Raver. Good luck.